Being Amish, that's kind of hard to explain because that's all we've ever known. We don't know any other way. Actually, do you mind if I face this way? I'm really kind of uncomfortable with cameras around. I'm not used to growing up with them. I'm not used to being around them.
Hey, Amy, step that way.
Okay, yeah, that's fine. You can look this way.
Is that easier?
Yes, that's better. I'm Barbie, I'm 22. I'm from Mumfordville, Kentucky, and I'm Amish. We do have a lot of chores, washing clothes, sewing, baking, ironing. There's always work to do. This is a cast iron. A lot of the Amish don't have electricity, so this is usually what we use. We usually heat it up on the stoves, get it nice and hot, and we're good to go. My dad's a preacher. Being a preacher's daughter, it's a lot of pressure because I know that everybody's watching me. I just can't be myself. Like, I gotta be what they want me to be. My family moved to Mumfordville because it's one of the strictest Amish communities in the country. They tell me what to eat, they tell me what to wear, they tell me what to do, they tell me what questions not to ask, they tell me what I need to ask. It's just so controlling. We're not allowed to date until we join church because we're supposed to commit our love to God before anyone else. I'm 22 and I'm just not ready to join church. I don't think they should be allowed to tell me when I should date or when I can date. I should be able to make those choices on my own and follow my own heart. For the past 2 years, I've had a serious boyfriend. His name is Lester. We used to sneak out behind my parents' back and meet at an old barn. Lester used to be Amish, but he left the community. I spend a lot of time with Lester in the English world, and since they found out, it's caused a lot of friction between me and my parents. But they always accept me back because deep down, they're hoping I'll come to my senses. Recently, Lester has proposed, and that's changed everything. It's forbidden to date, let alone be engaged to somebody who's left the Amish. So now I have to decide between marrying the love of my life or staying Amish and being with my family. If I do marry Lester, there's simply no coming back. Leaving the Amish is a huge risk because it's just really bad if a preacher's daughter leaves. It puts the whole family in a bad light. It just doesn't look good. Fun?
Yeah, but the fish ain't biting.
I've never met anyone like Lester. We always have so much fun. Like, he's the best thing that's ever happened to me. And I can't imagine life without him. But since Lester has left the Amish, I can't marry him unless he decides to come back. I have to choose between him and my family. So I'm really torn right now because I can't live without either one of them.
Don't let your family get in your head and make you feel like you're doing something wrong, because we all know better. We all know we don't have to drive a buggy to heaven. We don't have to be Amish to not go to hell. And I just want you to be comfortable knowing that you can be with me and that what we've been taught our whole life isn't 100% true.
Even though I'm not happy being Amish, this is how I was raised, and it's all I know. I wouldn't have the courage to do this without Lester supporting me. So will you wait for me while I go to New York?
How long do you think you'll be gone?
I don't know. I'm not sure. I'll just long enough to give it a good shot and see how I like it.
Come back ready to marry me.
Will you go with me when I go see my parents to tell them?
I don't want to go in there with you, but I'll take you there.
That's okay. I just want you to be there for me. I'm just worried about when I tell them, what's gonna happen. I might not be able to get to see them anymore.
You ready for this?
I'm nervous. Today, I'm going to tell my parents that I'm leaving for New York City, and I'm really scared. I don't know how they're going to take it. I don't know how this is going to go.
You'll be all right.
I hope so. I wasn't able to see my parents face to face, so I'm going to call them. Most Amish are allowed to have phones outside their houses, but we're allowed to have one in the garage for my dad's business.
Hello?
Hello?
Yeah.
Hey, it's Jemimda.
Yeah.
Davy Schwartz met him.
Are you on the phone, Dad?
Yeah. My dad knows something's up because I don't ever call his office.
Yeah, officially, so is, it's in New York, if you will.
Hello?
Is this a New York gift of you?
New York?
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll have it
from him. Oh. I mean, that's why it's, you know, that's why it's two of rules and stuff.
Two of rules? For realize to us and grow this sentence to me, Nagria, bitch. What are we talking about? Mustn't do it in that undercomer, it's doing undercomer countries, do not forget about it, can't trust him to be. Who isn't labor? This battle is. There's a grist labor. You may have only the Amish.
Well, hey, Amish, what kind of grist a man say to us?
Do you solve it considering Christian and labor and horror?
When I was growing up, I was daddy's girl. I was always with him. And like he was my best friend. And and hearing him say that to me, that wasn't my dad. My little sister was listening on the other line, and she just started crying. And I couldn't even finish. I had to hang up the phone. My sister, 7 years old, we're really close. She looks up to me, and now it just seems like I'm not there for her. Growing up Amish, all you have is each other. And if someone leaves, it is like a death in the family. If they shun you, it's like you're dead. Yeah, I'm so glad we didn't go in. I just had a bad feeling about it. I still didn't, you know, expect it to go like this. Why would family treat you like that?